Give to him glorious praise. I have been informed, my brethren, I serve members of Chloe's household, that you are quarreling among yourselves. This is what I mean. One of you will say, I belong to Paul, another I belong to Apollos. Still another, Cephas has my allegiance. And the fourth, I belong to Christ. Has Christ then been divided into parts? Was it Paul who was crucified for you? Was it in Paul's name that you were baptized? Thank God, I baptized none of you except Crispus and Gaius, so that there are none who can say that you were baptized in my name. Oh, and I baptized the household of Stephanus. Beyond that, I am not aware of having baptized anyone else. For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wordy wisdom. However, lest the cross of Christ be rendered void of its meaning.
Chrysler sort of remembered for many bands and such. But years ago, they So there was a TV actor who was popular in films and television. He had a foreign accent. He came out wearing a tuxedo, and he was promoting the virtues of this particular Chrysler sedan with the fine Corinthian leather.
Thing that we have that the good people
ought not apologize for what we believe. Sometimes it's a temptation to apologize to those around us who don't hold the same beliefs as we do. Maybe because we can't explain it. We don't have to apologize. We know the truth. We have the truth. We have an obligation to understand it better and better so that we can become better teachers to our kids, our grandkids, and to those around us. That's on us. But we have everything. All we have to do is choose to follow. And our Lord tells us in making those choices, and sometimes, like the early Corinthians, it will go against everything else that somebody else believes. Maybe even that somebody else who's very close to you, or who works with you or for you, or lives in your own house. But we know the truth. We know the answers. And we also know that in trying to live these baptismal promises, God is with us. I want to tell you a little story. You can probably figure out where this story is going, because it's one of those stories where you can say, oh, I know what's going to happen. I know what's going to happen. It's a good kind of story like that. But it reminds us of what we're talking about today. There's a story that the young Indian American, Native Indian braves, the young Native American men, going through a rite of passage, had to do something by themselves for their very first time. They had to spend, as a rite of passage, an initiation into adulthood. They had to spend time away from their family, away from their fathers, away from the camp, on their own, spend a night in the woods by themselves. And it was kind of challenging during this rite of passage for the young braves, because for the first time in their lives, they left the relative safety of the campfire, of the home, of the family, and of those who protect them. And so, for the first time in his life, a young brave would be all alone with no one to watch over him. And for those of you who've been out in the woods, we've got some scouts here. So for those of you who've been out in the woods by yourself, if you're not familiar with this, the first time you hear a noise, quick crack, leaves rustle, something chirp or bark, or growl, it's pretty eerie. And you can only let your imagination run wild as to what's all out there on the prowl. So after long and harrowing, sleepless night, the dawn finally breaks, and this young brave is just about ready to face the next day. And to his astonishment, he finds that all throughout the night, not too far away, there was a towering figure of a man, a warrior. Only a few feet away, with a bow and arrow in hand, it was the young warrior's father, who never left his sight. He couldn't see him, but he was always there, watching over his son, all throughout the dark, scary night. Friends, even though we can't always see God in the dark, scary nights that we face, in a world that has so many challenges, far more than they did in Corinth, we know that God is always with us. He is always watching over us. And perhaps that will give us the courage that we need to be his faithful disciples, living the baptismal promises that we made. Glory to Jesus Christ!
Glory to Jesus Christ! Brothers
and sisters,
let us all say with our own soul, with our own mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
worshiped and glorified. He spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I profess one baptism for the remission of sins. I expect the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand by this and all this speak and do to all the holy and offering beings.
Mercy please, a sacrifice of praise.
Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and Father and communion in the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
redeemed your church with your precious blood and given us the joy of celebrating the holy memory of our spiritual fathers and hierarchs. They rightly taught and enlightened us, explaining the word of your truth as you guided them in the harbor of your will. You worthily glorify those who glorify you. Make us worthy of their prayers and supplications, especially on this day, as we honor the fathers of the six ecumenical councils who rightly taught and enlightened us, so that by their holy and innocent lives, that we might serve you in fear and love, that together with all of our holy fathers and hierarchs, we might experience your favor and love for us all. For you are the provider and the giver of all good things, and we give glory to you, now and ever and forever.
Despise not our prayers and our need, but deliver
young girls, and their counselors who are starting camp, church camp. So please do lift up them in prayers, and we will sing for all of those and each one of us right now. May God grant to all of us here present, to every member of our parish family, to all those campers at Carpathian Village, and to all those who are traveling, peace, good health, and happiness.